Hello everyone, welcome back to another MTG Arena video. Today I'll be taking a look at a 0 rare Dimir control deck in the new March of the Machine standard. Now I've dubbed this deck anti-toxic, as every other deck that I've encountered in the queue so far has pretty much been some variation of toxic, which is a little disappointing because I am trying new decks. However, toxic is very good at the budget level, so it makes piloting these decks very difficult. I have included some of the new battles from the new set in this deck. At 3 mana we have Invasion of Armonkhet, which is a nice little Dimir piece for control. Our opponent discards one, we draw one, we each mill three, and then if we flip it, we can convert this creature to any creature in a graveyard, and that includes any creature with payoffs, which can be quite handy. At 4 mana, we have the 2 copies of Invasion of Rin, and when this enters the battlefield, we get to draw 3 cards and discard a card. So this is a somewhat decent replacement for our previous instant speed spells at 4 mana that allowed us to draw 2 cards. However, the real payoff with this one is if we can flip it, and then we can use that to copy any spell or any permanent that we control, basically. So we can use it to copy things like our Behold the Unspeakable or our Micromancer. Just really good cards that produce really good value for our budget deck. So real quickly going through the deck, we have our 2 copies of Runa's Vortex, 2 copies of Duress, and our 2 copies of Syncopate. And these are all searchable by our Micromancer. So if you're looking to mulligan a card early, Runa's Vortex and Syncopate you should be able to find later. Duress is obviously a card you'd like to play earlier in the game rather than late. At 2 mana we have 2 copies of Go for the Throat, our 4 copies of Shield Dread's Edict, and the 4 copies of Tainted Indulgence, good draw power. So Go for the Throat, just some easy removal for non-artifact creatures. Sheldred's Edict can deal with tokens, non-token creatures, and opponent's planeswalkers as well. So this is a very handy card that has saved me in quite a few difficult matchups. Tainted Indulgence, a great draw spell, and we have 6 different mana types, so we're very likely to get this to 5 different mana values within our graveyard. And cards like Invasion of Armonkhet would certainly help with this. At 3 mana we have our 4 copies of Thirst for Discovery, just some extra draw power. Also good for discarding to make things like Tainted Indulgence more viable. Our anti-toxic tech, the 4 copies of Malicious Malfunction, a great little piece at uncommon. So all creatures get -2/-2 till end of turn. And if a creature would die this turn, it gets exiled instead. So not only is this handy for the creatures that we're -2/-2ing, but because if a creature would die this turn, should we kill another creature with our Go for the Throat, or force our opponent to sacrifice with the Edict, then that creature will also get exiled as well. 4 mana, the 2 copies of Invasion of Rin, like I said, just another nifty draw piece, and should we be able to use the artifact, we can produce some extra value. Our 4 copies of Micromancer, a great card for this deck as it's a creature that can block, draw out heat, and provide some attack power, as well as searching one of our 6 one drops that we definitely like to have. And obviously the MVP of the deck, which I've played before, is Behold the Unspeakable. This also helps with the anti-toxic game plan, as we're reducing most toxic creatures will be 1-2 power, and this will reduce any 2 powered creature to 0, so the poison counters don't get through if they try to get in for damage. Lore 2, if we have one or fewer cards in hand, we get to draw 4. Otherwise, we scry 2 and then draw 2 cards. So, very good deck for keeping our hand stocked. And then when we exile this saga, we return it to the battlefield transformed under our control, the Vision of the Unspeakable, a flying trample enchantment creature, and it gets +1/+1 for each card in our hand. So at this stage of the game, with our numerous draw spells, we want to keep our hand stocked so that we can use this to finish off our opponent. Nothing fancy for the mana base. 10 islands, 10 swamps, 4 copies of Waterfront District. Just a card that we can sack in the late game to draw if we're finding ourselves empty for whatever reason. So all in all, this deck actually did better than most of the other decks that I've tried. I wanted to try and incorporate some other cards from March of the Machine. However, these 2 cards were definitely the standout. There are other battles in blue and black that you might wish to try, However, I don't think they fit with the overall theme of this deck, which is basically to stop small creature decks, specifically all the toxic decks that we're seeing. So I will keep at it, and I will try to produce more videos for Standard. However, if Standard becomes a bit unbearable due to the toxic, you might see me going back to Explorer or even Historic. So that's all for today. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoy the video, and I'll see you all next time.
Thank you. surrender your mind to Phyrexia's will. Become subdued.